Hello, my friend. God's highest, God's richest, God's deepest, God's widest blessings to you. I'm wondering if you could use some prayer. If so, please just post your prayer request there in the comment section, and you can count on the fact that some of us are going to pray for you. Thanksgiving is just around the corner. I love Thanksgiving. I love turkey. And I also love the reminder of the importance of gratitude. Why don't we start a series today, maybe 8 or so messages on gratitude. I have a new devotional out that talks about gratitude. It's called You Can Count on God. The widest river in the world is not the Mississippi, not the Amazon, not the Nile. It is a body of water called If Only. Throngs of people stand on its banks, and they cast longing eyes over the waters. They desire to cross, but they just can't seem to find the ferry. They are convinced the If Only River is what separates them from the good life. If only I were thinner, I'd have the good life. If only I were richer, I'd have the good life. If only the kids would come, if only the kids were gone. If only I could leave home, move home, get married, get divorced. The If Only River. Are you standing on its shore? Does it seem that the good life is always one if only away? If only is the petri dish in which the ungrateful heart thrives. Why don't you replace your if only with an already? Look what you already have. Did you know a grateful heart is also a healthy heart? One study conducted by Robert Emmons at the University of Berkeley, California, divided participants into three groups and asked them to maintain a journal for 10 weeks. One group was asked to write a list of 10 things for which they were grateful from the past week. The second group was asked to list 10 minor annoyances in the past week. And the third group was asked to write about 10 things that impacted their lives in the past week with no further direction. At the end of 10 weeks, the first group of people that were studied were reported feeling 25% more happier than the other groups. Now, this is no surprise. Colossians 3 speaks to us about a grateful heart, verses 15 through 17. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you are called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, with thankfulness in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through Him. Don't let the troubles of the world, dear friend, whether it is the greater world surrounding you or your inner world of turmoil, whether it be your family, whether it be your friends or lack thereof, don't let frustration rule in your hearts. Let gratitude rule in your hearts. And then the scripture promises you'll receive the peace of Christ. The good life is out there waiting for you, and you're actually probably already living it if you were just to take the time and acknowledge all the good you already have. Don't let the if onlys get you down. Here's to living the good life with thankfulness in our hearts. Oh, dear friend, be grateful today. Heavenly Father, today, create within each one of us a spirit of gratitude. We're surrounded by so many problems, so many struggles, but also, Father, we live lives in which we are showered with blessings. Thank you, Father. Have mercy, please, upon all of us as we seek to follow you more dearly, nearly, and dearly. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. Hey, have a great day, my friend. And don't forget who gave it to you.